What's up everyone, welcome to another Zoof Skills Fishing video. Today's video is a bit different. It's actually a tutorial. This was an idea by one of my subscribers, Chris Sibert. Hope I'm pronouncing your surname correctly. Thank you so much for the idea. Chris also suggested that I make more videos. So in the weeks ahead, guys, I'm planning on dropping a few more videos. I think I'm actually going to be planning one tomorrow as well. So thanks to Chris, thanks to all my other subscribers, guys. Thank you so much for the ideas and the tips and so on. It really helps me to, you know, grow the channel. I have a few good ideas that I'm going to come up with, or actually some videos that I have planned for the channel. So I believe this video is a very important video for my channel, because these knots that I'm going to go over, basically this is a tutorial on the knots that I use. It's part of a two-part series. This video will specifically be about the knots that I use for fresh bait fishing. So when I'm using fresh bait like sardine, squid, choka, if I'm using Japanese mackerel, tackle shrimp, these are the knots that I use for those setups. Also guys, it's basically knots and traces. So you can use these same knots and traces on your setups when you are fishing. I will do a separate video. Part two will be specifically the knots and the traces that I use for artificial lure angling. So guys, I started off as a fresh bait angler like most people, and these knots have helped me throughout the years. I actually landed a lot of good fish as well with these knots. So I hope this tutorial is beneficial to you as well. So without further ado, let's get into it. So guys, basically when it comes to my fishing, there are three specific knots that I use for majority of my fishing applications, and there's a fourth knot or trace that I use now and then. I'm gonna go over them in the specific order that I of importance, I'd say, that I use them in. So the first knot, very important knot, is a clinch knot. So let's go through the clinch knot very quickly. I'm gonna use my own method or way of explaining it to you, right? Excuse me. So here we have a bit of snag on this line, so let's remove that. Always guys, when you are preparing your traces, always use a good quality scissors. I'm using a Pro Hunter scissor. It's a braid and mono fluoro scissor, so you can use it for all different types of line. Very sharp, very effective. So guys, I do have this hook that I'm going to use, just to give you a bit more of an idea of how to actually prepare the trace. Using a smaller hook, you would be able to see it as well, but I think it's much more defined when I use this hook. I specifically bought this hook for tutorials. So the first hook, guys, the first knot, guys, that I'm going to go over is the clinch knot. So it's a very simple knot, very effective knot. Now, there's two ways I do it. It's the normal clinch knot, and then I have my own twist on it as well. The reason why I try to adjust it, or I won't say improve it, but adjust it, is because in certain conditions you need the hook to be able to have a bit of give, a bit of move. Not in all instances, sometimes it could be to your detriment, but based on the type of fish you are targeting, you might need the hook to move around. So I'm going to explain that as well. So here's the original way of doing the clinch knot, and then I'll do my version thereafter. So very simple guys, you put it through the eye of the hook, you bring it over just like this, right? So you have a V basically. So you're holding the tag in with the line. Now, of course, this line is coming off your rod. So the tip of your rod, and you're gonna put the tag in off that line through the eye of the hook. Once you do that, all you do is simply twist it. I tend to twist it about 6 or 7 times. Seven's my lucky number. So just in that, this with the same action. Let's do that again, right? So you put it through. Twist it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All you do thereafter is you push it through that small loop that is created at the bottom of those twists. I'm not sure if you can see that right there. You push it through there. So once you do that, guys, all you do is you can wet the line right here. And you just pull down, just like that. There you go. Awesome. And that's a clinch knot. very strong knot, but of course you need to wet it. So what that does is actually makes it clinch faster than, as the name says, clinch. It clinches onto the hook. As you can see, there's no give, almost no give. Right? All you do is cut off your tag end, like so, and you're good to go. Okay, guys, I use this for majority of all my fishing applications when it comes to fresh bait. Right? It's an awesome knot to use. I actually even use this knot on my swivels and so on. So what I'm gonna do for you guys now is I'm gonna quickly prepare I call it a running trace. So a running trace is basically a sinker on your main line connected to a swivel, and then that swivel is connected to your hook line, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut this line as an example of hook and line, right? So here's the hook that we just tied the clinch knot on. You can see it there. Sorry about that, guys. I'm getting my camera to actually, right? That's it there. And now what we're gonna do is I'm going to prepare a running sinker on a running sinker trace. So all you need for that is a ball sinker. I tend to use a ball sinker. You can use a pyramid sinker like this or a bucket sinker. You can even use a grapnel sinker, right? I prefer to use a ball sinker for this application when you're doing a running trace because it's actually much more, I'd say, snag resistant, prevents the sinker from getting stuck on rocks and so on because of the shape. Okay, so let's prepare the running trace. What I'm going to do is very quickly, guys, just take some extra line here, that's Daiwa Justron line. Imagine this line is coming off the rod tip, right? Okay, so imagine this is your rod tip, and here's your line. All you're going to do is very quickly take your sinker that you have. Very quickly. Also like to use a bead in the front, and I'll explain that shortly. So what we do is you take your sinker as is, right? And you put your line through that specific sinker. In this case, a ball sinker. As you can see, the line is through the sinker. Awesome, right? I then take a bead. You can get this at your tackle stores when you're buying your terminal tackle. And I insert the bead in front of the sinker. Once I do that, right, I then can use a swivel, a normal two-way swivel. This is a power swivel. And I connect the swivel to the main line. And the reason why I put the bead is because of the friction between the two metal pieces. That's basically the metal sinker and the swivel. So you do not want the line to get obviously damaged. So the bead tends to protect the knot. And I'll show you what happens. So guys, very quickly, I'm tying a clinch knot here. Very quick one. There we go. So we have our sinker running off the main line with the bead. The bead actually covers the knot, and we have the swivel. Okay. Then what you do is you're then going to take your hook line. Okay. And you're going to connect it to that swivel. So remember, the knot we used was a clinch knot. Very versatile knot. Once again, I'm going to use the clinch knot here. Again, very quickly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here we go. Oops, lost two knots there. Two twists, sorry. There we go. Put it through, push it through very quickly. Wet the line, pull it down. There we go, good to go. So here's your trace, guys. You got your ball sinker or running trace sinker. With the bead protecting your knot, you have your swivel, two clinch knots, each side of the swivel. Very important. And then you have your final clinch knot on the hook. This is an amazing trace when targeting fish that feed in the bottom, especially if you are fishing sandy bottoms. Like I use this trace for spotted grunter, for my blacktail, and so on and so forth. I even use it for fishing for pompano on sandy bottoms and with a great degree of success. So, guys, clinch knot, very important, not a part of my repertoire of knots. I use it almost all the time. I even use it when I'm fishing artificial lures. It's a very important knot, okay? So I did obviously allude to the fact that I have my own take on it as well. So it's just small variation to the clinch knot. So here we go, guys. I'm just gonna clear out this knot quickly, just cut it off. Here we go. Just remove those once it ends there. Awesome. So this is my take on it. Right, so obviously the normal clinch knot process, once again, main line or hook line through the eye of the hook, create that V, and then you twist 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now the normal clinch knot is you put it through here and you pull down. Put it through the loop at the bottom, pull down. My variation is once I do that, can you see this loop? Before tightening it and wetting the line, there is a small loop. How is this loop created? When you are putting your tag in through the bottom loop, just before you clinch the knot, there's a loop that's created when you do that. I tend to put the tag in through that loop as well. Now, because there's so many loops, I think I need to wet this line very quickly. Just using saliva for now. Of course, you can use water, whatever is available at the time. Okay, guys, I'm pulling down on this knot, right? Hook is very sharp. Okay, awesome. Let me just cut off the tag end quickly. Okay. Now, the advantage of this, it might not be able to be. Okay, actually, you can. The advantage of that extra loop is it allows the line to move freely. So, if you're fighting, as you can see, it doesn't diminish the strength of the knot. All it does is it allows the knot to move freely around the eye of the hook. So if you are fighting fish that tend to split the hook or have those vicious head shakes, violent head shakes, and they tend to get off the hook very easily, just by putting that, this is my own personal preference, guys. You don't have to do this. This is my improvised clinch knot approach. It works for me when I'm targeting certain species. By putting that tag in through that extra loop, it just gives the knot a bit more give. So that's my take on it. Just a tip, personal tip. Something I learned from my experience, my own personal experience, and I hope it can help you as well. So, guys, very important, the clinch knot and the Zoof Skills improvised clinch knot. Very important knot in my repertoire. Okay, awesome. So that's the clinch knot, guys. Moving on to another very important knot that I use. After doing some research, so guys, based on where you come from, different parts of the world, you have your own terminology or names for different things, right? So I used to call this the overhead loop knot, but after doing some research on the internet, I found out it's actually called a surgeon's end knot. Very important knot. I actually use this for my sinkers. I do not use it for ball sinkers. I use it predominantly for my pyramid sinkers or diamond sinkers as they're known, or my bucket sinkers. Okay, so how I normally use it though is when I'm attaching a three-way swivel to my trace. This case, let's get it. So of course, guys, in this instance, you'll have line coming off from your tip of the rod, right? You'll have one, so your main line will be on one swivel head, okay, on one swivel head. Your hook line will be on another swivel head, and you'll have your sinker on the last one. So basically what you're doing is you are holding the hook, or you're suspending the hook in the water because your sinker is at the bottom. So you have your main line on one swivel head, hook line, and your sinker line. So once again, guys, we're going to apply or implement the clinch knot. So let me do that very quickly. So guys, I'm only preparing the sinker line right now. So put it through one of the swivel heads. Quickly apply a clinch knot. Here you don't have to improvise, you don't have to use the Zoop Skills clinch knot. You just use your normal clinch knot. Just a tip, guys, what most people do, most guys do, especially when they're fishing rocky bottoms, is they tend to use lighter or weaker poundage line for the sinker. For the sinker trace or line, because should you hook a big fish, you'd rather lose the sinker than the fish. So if the sinker gets stuck in the rocks or in the bricks, as we say in South Africa, you lose the sinker, you won't lose your fish. That's just a tip. A lot of people tend to downsize their line strength for the sinker line. So here's a clinch knot, right, guys? What I tend to do is I normally leave about, let's say, quarter of a meter. Right? Let me cut that off. Here we go. So here's my three-way swivel, right? I'm only preparing the sinker line. Remember, you got your main line and your hook line on the other two swivel heads. Here we go. Just for tutorial purposes, I'm using a small piece of line. Very simple. All you do is you loop it over like so. Here we go. You loop it over like so. Okay, so there's a tag end there. You just loop it over. I tend to use two fingers. Okay, so it's a bit short, so let me just go higher up. So you've looped the line, right? I tend to use two fingers. I hold it at the top and I make an overhead loop. Push it through. Let's do that one more time, right? Here's your line coming off the swivel. You loop it on itself, turn it on itself. You then use your two fingers to hold the tag end and the connection to the swivel, and you create a loop, overhead loop. And what I tend to do, guys, is I pull it right through. Depending on how far you want it, I create a loop. There we go. Okay, awesome. Now, the advantage of this is very. Advantage of this is very simple. What it does for you is, it increases the knot or the line strength by 100%. So, how do you actually hook up your sinker to this? Very simple. Let's use the bucket sinker for this example. All you do is you take the bottom of that loop, you push it through the sinker hold. And then you push it through the middle of that loop. There you go. So what it does is it's actually holding your sinker right here. The advantage of this is twofold. You're increasing your line strength by 100%. So it's twice as strong. And not only that, should you for whatever reason need to change your sinker size, very simple. You just push the line down on itself, and you can remove the sinker, right? Pull out the loop. Let's say you want to use a heavier sinker. Maybe there's some undercurrent that you never account for. Then you use a larger sinker, like in this case, I'm using the sinker here. Quickly push the loop through again. This is going to be a bit tricky, but let's see if I can do it. Okay. Awesome. Push it through the loop again. Boom, Bob's your anchor. Awesome. Right? Now, from time to time, guys, with the pendulum force and the weight of the sinker, from time to time, this knot normally can break. It does break. So let me just create that scenario. Let's say it broke. Boom. Okay. Now you have your sinker that's stuck on this line. Let's say your sinker's lost at sea. Let's say if our soul's lost at sea. Right? You now have this broken sergeant ends knot or overhead loop knot, as I call it. Very simple. If you are strapped for time, this is what I'd normally do. I'd cut off one end, normally the shorter end, like so. And I would then apply quick clinch knot. This is just an improvisation. clinch knot to that sinker that I've added with my new sinker. Let's do that very quickly. And as you can see, guys, within a matter of seconds, I've prepared another sinker. Right? So that's the advantage. Twofold, actually, I'd say threefold. Number one, it increases your line strength by 100%, so it makes your knot twice as strong. It allows you to change the size of your sinkers very quickly. And should the knot break, you can then adjust it by just applying a clinch knot to the tag end of what's remaining of that broken trace knot. So I really like the surgeon ends knot, or the overhead loop knot, as I call it. Very important knot for me. I use it for majority of my fishing, bottom fishing. Awesome. Okay, so now we're on to the third knot. It's basically a very important knot for me when I'm live baiting or when I'm throwing out chunky baits, and I need maybe more than one hook attached to the baits. It could be a live bait, or maybe like a chunk of bonito or a large piece of choker, something like that. What I'll do is I would use a snell knot. So snell knot is a very simple knot. I'll use an example, right? By using this hook, all you do is, let's get some line here. So what I normally do is I put it through the eye of the hook. So this is your main line coming off the tip of your rod. Put it through there, through the eye of the rod. Sorry, through the eye of the hook. I then create a loop at the bottom, on the shank of the. Put some more line there. All I do is then create maybe six or seven twists, like so. One, two, three, four, five, six. You then take the tag end, put it through the loop of the hook at the bottom, the loop of the knot at the bottom, and you pull the main line up to the eye of the hook. You can lubricate it with saliva or water, right? And you pull that through. Awesome. This one doesn't look that neat because of the line diameter in comparison to the diameter of the shank. But basically, what happens is pulls down on itself. There you go. And if this tag end is, of course, longer, you can add a second hook by using a clinch knot, right? And you have two hooks that you can now add to your bait. You can use this in the bot on the top of perhaps your live bait. And then the other hook you could use at the head of the live bait for whatever reason, or just to add two hooks onto maybe a larger profile fresh bait, like a chunk of bonito if you're going shark fishing or in edibles and so on. So very important knot, guys. Snell knot, very simple knot. Let's do it one more time. Here we go. Here's your hook, your main line from your rod tip. Put it through the eye of the hook, bring it down the bottom of the shank of the hook. When you do that, you're of course creating a loop at the bottom. You pinch it very quickly at the bottom, like so. Okay, keep that loop at the bottom. You're then going to twist the line around the shank of the hook. One, two, three, four, five, six. Guys, make sure you're looping it on top of each loop, so it's done in a very uniform and neat manner. You then put your tag in through the bottom of that loop, like so. You lubricate it, and you pull the main line up towards the eye of the hook. There we go. Very simple knot. You can then use a clinch knot, as I said, on the tag end to add another hook if you need. Awesome stuff. Okay, so guys, the last trace or knot that I'm going to talk about, it has a funny name, or it sounds funny to me. It's colloquially known as the Gundu knot or Gundu trace. I don't know how the name came about, but basically, guys, it's when you're trying to create or you need two hooks coming off one line. Very simple, guys. This is your hook line, right? It's gonna be connected to your main line. Here's the server. So this line is basically for one hook at the moment. What you do is you use a surgeon end loop knot, as I call it, an overhead loop knot, like so. Create the loop, right? Two fingers overhead, and then you put the loop through. There you go. Okay, and then all you do is you cut it wherever you deem it necessary, and now you have two tag ends that you can add knots to. So let me do that very quickly. Okay, so here we go. I have two hooks. Okay. This is normally used when you're targeting shoals of fish, where you know you can hook two or three at a time. So all you do is going to use your clinch knot, attach hooks to each tag end. There we go. I have one attached already, and then add the second hook. Let me lubricate the knot very quickly. Awesome. Here we go. So guys, I have two knots here. Looks a bit untidy, so let me just take out the tag ends real quick. Go. There you go. So now I have two hooks that will be floating in the water, especially when I'm targeting shoals where I can hook two fish at once. So saves time, saves energy, work smart, not always hard. There you go. So that's the last trace or knot that I'd like to talk about, guys. I use these knots predominantly. I hardly use anything else, and I've had great success over the years. So yeah, guys, I hope this tutorial was beneficial to you. Please like, share, subscribe. I plan on uploading many more videos, and thank you so much for the support, guys. I really do appreciate it. I'm gonna be setting up some other social media platforms. I already started, but once everything is set up, most likely in my next video, I'll give you a bit of an update on that. Thank you so much, guys. Stay tuned for more amazing fishing action. And thanks for all the support. Cheers.